and eventually defeat the almighty Centralians with the culminating battle ending in Moundtown. All the SBCs had different MOS backgrounds, which would in the end put the enemy in the ultimate combined arms dilemma. In order to be effective, it took a no-holds-bar approach on instilling discipline on us young lieutenants. For example, Captain Ruge would never miss the opportunity to threaten us with being dropped if we messed with his ordnance.
Kill.
Captain Farley would train his Marines on how to use the standard-issue baseball bat. Or maybe use it as a discipline tool. To this day, we still don't know. Captain Reinhardt gave us a good understanding of the principles of fire support. Captain Turner taught 5th Platoon how to successfully manipulate a spring-loaded pocket knife. Captain Foley ran on physical fitness, and Captain Berenson was our expert on AAVs. And how could I forget our executive officer, Captain Steinfeld, who would often remind us that page 87, paragraph 4 of MCDP-1 is of vital importance, and that we should not only in fact have read for warfighting 8 times, but it should in fact be memorized. And finally, we would never miss out on the opportunity to go on liberty without an inspiring history lesson from our company commander. With all the great guidance and leadership that these fine officers have bestowed upon us, I can truly attest to the fact that we are well prepared to lead the nation's finest here in the near future. As for our training here on Camp Barrett, it began with learning the basic rifleman tactics and ended with platoon reinforced operations. From McMap to land navigation to marksmanship training on the rifle range, we would all soon become proficient on how to shoot, move, and communicate. FEX 1 was our first live fire movement range, which I can say went quite well. Although I do credit much of our success to the abundance of hot chow that always seemed to raise morale. And how could we forget Final Land Nav, where some of us would learn the valuable lessons on waterproofing our gear. FEX 2 and FEX 3 were both similar in nature, as there was just as much animosity between all the platoons. I recall when Lieutenant Brothers from 5th Platoon would do anything possible to plan the perfect attack. He even infiltrated 6 platoon lines while playing the role of an AI as he mapped out every enemy fighting position. To me, that is what I call the perfect leader's recon. Finally, our continuous conflict with the CRF culminating in the city of Moundtown, where our skills would be put to the ultimate test. Braving the heat of 90 to 100 degrees, I can now confidently say that our mission has been accomplished. And the Centralian Revolutionary Forces have finally been destroyed. TBS has also left us with a whole new range of vocabulary words to use when we leave here. There are what many call the famous TBS-isms. For some reason, now I refer to my brain as a toolbox, and everything that I now learn are now tools. And apparently we can no longer use the words relieve or appease. From now on, we shall only use the word mitigate. We have shared many good moments together, and it's finally time to say farewell to our beloved O'Bannon Hall. I know for myself, I will definitely miss such spacious accommodations. As we begin the first page of our Marine Corps career, or as Major Moran would put it, the end of football summer camp, some of us will soon endure the greatest privilege that our country can bestow upon its citizens, the privilege of leading the United States Marines. As we depart our separate ways, many of us will face different challenges. Just always remember to look out for those under your charge, and they will in turn look out for you. We are at a pivotal point in time in history, a time that requires the dedication of its citizens to ensure the success of our country and Corps. As our grandfathers and fathers have done before us, many of whom are with us today, we must continue to fight and keep our country free, and remain committed to fighting and winning our nation's battles. As my former MEF commander, General Mattis, said on the eve of the invasion of Iraq, for the mission's sake, our country's sake, and the sake of the man who carried the division's colors in the past, who fought for life and never lost their nerve, carry out your mission and keep your honor clean. Demonstrate to the world that there's no better friend, no worse enemy than a U.S. Marine. It's been an honor to serve with each and every one of you, and I wish you all great success in the near future. God bless, and Semper Fi Dallas Bravo Company, C. Smith, Sergeant Major, Instructor Battalion. Lieutenant Colonel James Davis, commanding officer, instructor battalion, the basic school. Colonel Christopher Gunther, United States Marine Corps, retired. Sergeant Major William Skiles, Sergeant Major, weapons training battalion. Colonel Michael Mulligan, commander, training command. Colonel George W. Smith, Jr., commanding officer, the basic school. Major Kobe Moran, commanding officer, the basic school. Lieutenant Colonel Stephen Jericholis, executive officer, the basic school. Colonel Frederick Padilla, Marine Corps Combat Development Command. Sergeant Major Michael D. Grew, Sergeant Major, Manpower Management Division, Headquarters Marine Corps. Colonel Carl J. Mundy III, Chief of Staff, Joint IED Defeat Organization. Sergeant Major Richard Ashton, Sergeant Major, the Basic School. On behalf of all the officers of the mess, I express our pleasure in having you here this evening.
When I was a battalion commander in 2nd Battalion, 6th Marines, then Lieutenant Moran was one of my platoon commanders, both in a rifle platoon and 81s. I'm sure by this point in the curriculum, he's told you what a superb lieutenant he was. For a couple of adult beverages of my choice, I'll tell you the rest of the story later this evening, or one of his fellow lieutenants, his 4 or 5 of them here, but it's all good. All right. I will tell you, I've got some very clear memories of my time at the basic school. And I frankly remember pretty vividly the mess night I attended for the first time as a second lieutenant. But as I prepared to come down here tonight, I recall that I don't have a clue who the guest speaker was at the mess night, let alone whatever he might have said. And I'm mindful of that as I start. Tonight is not about long speeches. It's about the opportunity to enjoy each other's camaraderie, so I won't make a long speech. But I got to tell you, nights like tonight present an opportunity.